liability and budget. Because, you know, right now, Forsyth County is being held liable for the Braidwood Dam on Lake Alice. Now, Forsyth County did not build the dam, did not build the lake, but they allowed the zoning. So I see all those creeks there, and I'm wondering how long Forsyth County is held liable for the creeks that flood.
The question again, for anybody who couldn't hear, was the liability of the county for the creeks flooding. I think I know the case you're talking about with the dam blew out. I don't know the details of it.
This project is going to finance lawsuits that are going to arise out of that.
The county typically with the detention pond, which is really where you have the problem, the detention pond fails, it causes runoff, that kind of thing. That's where you see a lot of lawsuits filed.
That wasn't our dam. That wasn't our lake.
Well, I understand.
The only liability we really have is the fact that we allow the zoning.
Well, I'm not.
And now we're talking about allowing the zoning of 696 homes right up against creeks. We mentioned the water runoff. I know that there will be flooding. You know there will be flooding. And it won't be long before Forsyth County finds itself sued again.
By the same family that's brought the zoning.
Just a second.
The same family that brought the zoning is suing, proposing to sue the county for flooding.
I want to address my issue about the runoff. The question again was a concern about runoff. Keep in mind that when the project is developed, the development will have curb and gutter, storm drains, piping systems to go to the detention ponds. You're not going to see sheet flow coming off the property like you do now. Where we're keeping the streams and the buffers, that helps slow down and filter some of that water. Most of it is piped into retention ponds where it is held and released more slowly. Yes, physics works. When you put more stuff on the ground that water doesn't sink into, it increases runoff. But the way the law is written, you can't increase the runoff off of your property to any more than it was before you did anything to it. So what the flow is now, the rate of that cannot increase. Does it? I guess it probably has to.
Yes, it does.
Yes, I recommend it.
I can guarantee you that.
But really what that concern is a concern about following the law. Well, when you're dealing with somebody like Lennar, I can assure you they're usually a lot more concerned about that than maybe somebody who has no stake in it who might flip it or something like that. Todd can speak to this more clearly than I can, but I can't imagine the hurdles that you guys and the controls put in place to limit that kind of thing.
Not only do we have to abide by the county laws, but we also have to abide by state and government laws. Being a publicly held company, we not only develop obviously here, but we do it all across the nation. So it's something that we take very seriously. If we were not diligent in our engineering, diligent in our developing, we wouldn't be able to continue doing what we're doing. We wouldn't be able to do this for 50 years. The same concerns that you have, we have. It doesn't behoove us to allow runoff into streams and allow it to bypass. All it does is aggravate our homeowners and aggravate the downstream homes. This is something, we want this community to be here now, 10 years, 20, 30 years in the future. We don't develop at minimum standards. We are doing everything we can to maximize the efficiency, maximize the engineering, so that we don't have these issues. And we work with all the county. Very important that we work with all of the county departments to make sure that we're doing it by the book.
Okay.